Hi guys, welcome back to today's video. It's been a while since the release of the brand new Apple 24-inch iMac, and maybe you've noticed the brand new magnetic connector, which comes with a special power adapter that can support 143 watts. You can even use it to connect to the Ethernet. So that's what we're gonna tear down today. It's like a brick when held. The Apple logo is in the middle, very shallow. Two ports are on the side. The three-prong interface is an independent module, and the power cord is detachable. The Ethernet port is next to it, pretty interesting. The specs info is on the other side, model is A2290. It can support input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 2 amp, and the output is 15.9 volts, 9 amp. The white sleeve can protect the junction. What we got is a green iMac. So the woven cable also adopts light green and is pretty thick and durable. The connector is a blue cylinder and integrates magnets. There are 12 contacts inside. It checks automatically without the need for precise alignment. And the lengths, widths and height are 96, 96 and 29 mm. And the cable length is about 2 meters. The total weight is about 437 grams. Next, let's take it apart directly. Use the Dremel to cut off the shell. And use the spudger to pry and open it. The shell is very thick, and the internal layout is just like other Apple chargers, pretty neat. All the components are black. The power cord is fixed by screws, and let's remove it. The yellow ground wire and the Ethernet port are welded on the same small PCB. Then let's take out the entire module. The Ethernet wire is fixed in the gap by glue and connects to the junction. Cut off the power cord. A total of 3 screws is used to fix the junction. Turn the bag, is covered with a metal heat sink and fixed by screws. Most of the plug-in components are on the front. Remove the screws. Both sides are also wrapped by the heatsink. There is an insulating layer inside the heatsink. The two hollow areas correspond to switch MOSFET of PFC boost and half bridge, improving the heat dissipation effect. And then remove the isolation plate and take out the Ethernet wire. Now the module is much clearer, and there is enough space for heat dissipation. There are lots of black thermosilicons on the back. We have to clean it up first. Okay, here we go. This is the tubular fuse protected by insulating tube. Rated current is 4 amp. Two common mode chokes are above the fuse used to filter out EMI interference. The varistor is used for input overvoltage protection. The gray cube is safety X capacitor, 0.33 microfarad. The scar is accidentally left when we cut the case. Here is the GBL10 bridge rectifier. The blue filter capacitor is marked with FPS2W105. Another blue filter capacitor is at the center of the PCB. There is also a filter inductor between two filter capacitors. The PFC boost controller comes from NXP TEA19162, which boosts the rectified voltage. It integrates X capacitor discharge components and supports high precision voltage regulation. Those two switch MOSFETs for PFC boost come from Infineon 60C185C7, the customized model for Apple. This diode is used for PFC boost rectification. Here is the STMicroelectronics TVS diode, used for current detection and protection, modulates SMA6F5.0A. Here is the PFC boost inductor, and the electrolytic capacitor comes from Rubycon, 450V, 120 microfarad. Here is the resonant capacitor, and the resonant inductor is next to it. The capacitor for powering the mass control chip is also from Rubycon, 35V, 47 microfarad. The primary controller of LLC power supply comes from NXP TEA19161T. It can work with PFC boost controller to improve the conversion efficiency. The half-bridge MOSFET also comes from Infineon, same model as the PFC boost MOSFET. Another giant cube is the transformer. Here is the Y capacitor. The optocoupler is on the back, used to regulate output voltage. And the secondary synchronous rectification controller comes from NXP TEA2095, which is dedicated to LLC topology with two building drivers. Those two LLC synchronous rectifiers are from ON Semiconductor NTMFS5C628L, 60V, 2.4 milliohm. Here are two solid capacitors for output filtering, which are conductive polymer capacitors from Panasonic SEPF series, 20V, 560 microfarad, at 5,000 hours. The protocol chip comes from Infineon CYPD C1185B2, used to control output power, and is the same model used in iMac. The output protection IC comes from Nexperia and adopts LFP-AK56 package, 30V, 1 milliohm. And this is the Ethernet port. The network transformer and filter inductor are welded on that small PCB. The junction is protected by glue. Well, that's all components for this Apple 143W power adapter. Actually, we've torn down lots of Apple PD chargers, but it's the first time for us to take apart the iMac power adapter. They look the same, but are different inside. For example, the Ethernet port, which is a pretty innovative design. The power cord is fixed by 3 screws, so it's very easy to change the power cords of different colors in factory. Most components come from well-known brands like Infineon, NXP, ON Semiconductor, Rubycon, so it maintains Apple's consistent high quality. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can also click the corners to take a look at other Apple products we've torn down. If you like this video, please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!